we do have some news, notes, and nuggets to tackle in our weekly hobby happenings segment. And here's a look at what's happening. Well, PSA has teamed up with Loop to bring new Collectors Club members even more value to their $99 annual membership fee. In addition to members only grading specials and pricing, those joining the club also receive a yearly subscription to the PSA magazine, a copy of the latest coffee table book from Tom and Ellen Zappala, the Diamondbacks collection, detailing Ken Kendrick's amazing vintage collection. But now the first year membership cost is entirely offset by a $100 Loop credit, making this an even bigger plus for collectors. You can visit psacard.com/join for more details.
Who wouldn't want an opportunity to win a $100 gift card to DA Card World? Well, now's your chance. Rob, myself, and the rest of the GTS marketing and editorial team are continually looking to improve the user experience on GoGTS.net. So if you haven't already done so, please take this short user survey and when completed, enter your email address. We promise not to add your email to any list. However, it is how we draw a random winner and contact them. The survey is open until January 13th, so get in today.
Absolutely. Speaking of mailing lists, though, if you want to be the best informed collector in the hobby, we can help. Keep your pulse on the hobby by subscribing to The Hobby Wire, our weekly newsletter that showcases the latest hobby interviews, athlete collecting profiles, checklists, product solicitations, new releases, and much more. You can sign up using the URL bit.ly/hobbywire.
Nice. Collectible recently launched a new short video series entitled How to Collect. Now, much like most of you, we don't really like to be told how to collect. However, based on the first video's tip of being an informed collector, we think the title doesn't align with the quality of the content. Watch Collectible's first tip.
Tip one. An informed buyer is a happier and more confident investor and collector. Once you've ventured into the collectibles world, take your time to really educate yourself prior to spending your hard-earned money. First and foremost, do not be afraid to ask questions. This is a very welcoming community, and everybody's willing to answer any questions you might have as you delve deep into this amazing space. Veteran hobbyists and collectors and investors are often more than happy to act as a mentor to you as you begin and explore your journey. Be a sponge. They can certainly help you really understand when great opportunities present themselves, but more importantly, they can certainly help you avoid a lot of the common pitfalls that we've experienced over the course of our industry's history. There are also many resources available to you, many of them free, to help you become a more informed and confident investor and collector. Numerous websites offer an abundance of content, many of them quite in-depth, about a lot of the things you'll need to know as you invest and collect in the sports collectibles industry. Remember, no one person knows everything. There is just too much to know about this vast space. But like everything else, information is power, and you need to do everything you can to educate yourself and inform yourself as best as you possibly can. It takes a little bit of time to become well-versed in a particular field, but believe me, it is well worth its weight in gold.
This week, PSA announced several pricing and service level updates to help collectors simplify the submission process with multiple pricing tiers, service values, and declared values to fit the needs of any collector budget. For more details, visit psacard.com/services/trading-card-grading.
It's only 5 days into the new year, and we already have some crime news. Meet Megan Simpson Borscher of Leesburg, Florida. She's doing wonders for Florida because I'm in Florida. I don't know her. Borcher was placed under arrest this week for scheming to defraud and theft by deception. So what did she do exactly? Well, she arranged to trade a friend's tools for a baseball card collection. Noble. Borcher's friend arrived at the Fruitland Park property in time to see two men loading his tools and other property into a trailer. He was able to block them from leaving and called the police. Upon their arrival, the men showed the responding officers a string of text messages negotiating with Borcher for the trade. She was taken to the Lake County Jail, where bond was set at $4,000.
A loser.
Doing Florida proud. Love it. Beautiful.
And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.